thank you much. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the City of Angels, Los Angeles, California. The City of Angels showing it can be loud and raucous. This was the scene a moment ago as the home squad emerged from the tunnel. They're ready for football and ready to watch their Rams do battle. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line with the Denver Broncos. On first down, it's gone. And the open receiver, it's Robert Woods. A good start offensively. 15 yards on the game's initial play. Woods coming off by far the best year of his career. 86 catches, over 1,200 yards. Now he's hoping to build on that, but boy, he was a key cog in the wheel that took them to the Super Bowl last season. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. Gone. It's hauled in by Brandon Cooks. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. A gain there of 12 yards and a first down L.A. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? So a jump there defensively.
It's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
So a first and five now after the five-yard penalty from the neutral zone infraction. A shotgun snap for Goff. Open man right side is Kupp, complete. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. It'll be a gain of six that time as it moves the chains as well.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Into heavy traffic and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kareem Jackson. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now the young man who was a Pro Bowler as an undrafted rookie, it's Philip Lindsay. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage. Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. Jeff Heirman, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
But they certainly didn't waste any time throwing some deep passes here. But the defense, it wasn't unexpected. They told their secondary, be ready. You're going to be tested all night by this team.
They come up now third and five following the incomplete pass. Operating out of the gun, Flacco. Yeah, that one's going to be knocked away and incomplete. The veteran Eric Weddle there to break that one up.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
Second-year punter Colby Wadman out there now for the Broncos. JoJo Natson back deep for the Rams. And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. The Rams offense heading out, and look, a lot of focus since the Super Bowl loss has been on Todd Gurley. The offseason revealed he had an arthritic component to his knee, for whatever that's worth. But the Rams went out, they got Daryl Henderson in the third round of the draft. They made re-signing Malcolm Brown a priority. What do you make of this Rams backfield starting 2019?
Well, the number one priority is to find out if Todd Gurley will play at the same level he's been playing. and the Rams seem optimistic that he can. Wouldn't surprise me at all if they cut down some of his carries and touches in order to get him through the season a little bit better. But last year, they were rescued by C.J. Anderson late in the season, what he did as a backup. So Malcolm Brown, you know, Daryl Henderson, the rookie, they have to play to that level in order for this Rams offense to continue to purr.
Now on second down, this is Gurley. And he'll take it forward for about five up to the 28-yard line.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
A nickel set defensively for the Broncos here on third down. Out of the gun, Goff. It's complete. This is Todd Gurley. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Here we go. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it. Occasionally, you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. We're scoreless after one. Second quarter now from Los Angeles. It is the Rams in possession as they've got it with a first and 10.
180. You. Watch the ship. Hey.
On first down, it's Gurley. And he's going to get stopped up quickly. Give him a yard down to the 43.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Tighten up.
Pull
together.
On second and 9, Goff. He's got Higbee complete right side. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
And, partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
From the gun on third down, Goff. And he's going to be taken down. Goff is sacked. Von Miller doing what he does best with a sack. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest ones, maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
Well, we got a moment here on the possession change. You know, it was a tough offseason for the Broncos organization. Their longtime owner, Pat Bowlen, passed away back on June the 19th, a little more than a month away from his induction into the Pro Football Hall of Fame.
And remember John Elway, who played for the Broncos during the time Pat Bowlen took over the team and won the Super Bowls with him as the owner? He spoke eloquently of him and actually lovingly. And remember that Super Bowl, the first one that the Broncos won there with Elway? What did Pat Bowlen say at the ceremony when they gave him the Lombardi Trophy? This one's for John. So you can tell that their relationship was pretty darn special. So, you know, it's unfortunate, the loss of Pat Bowlen, but he'll be long remembered in the NFL and, of course, in Denver.
And after they won Super Bowl 50, didn't John Elway say something back to Pat?
He certainly did. He grabbed the trophy there because, remember, John Elway now is running the team and said, this one's for Pat. Pretty good symmetry there.
The Rams go nickel here defensively on third. Flacco from the gun. And that's complete to the tight end Heuerman. And he'll be brought down with the first down and a late flag here too. And he may get a few more tacked on for good measure. So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they're marching off another 15 against your squad.
Now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. Flacco. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. To pass, Flacco. And Sutton hauls it in over the middle. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Now Flacco. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
Good route, good pickup for first down yardage, and that is a tough one to cover, the angle route, because a running back getting out of the backfield, if you're trying to cover that, especially if you're in the linebacker spot and you're seeing this play develop, he heads out towards the flat first, and that often gets you to overcommit running in that direction. Then he cuts back up inside you into the middle of the field. That's what we just saw there for a nice pickup. It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
Second and 10, Flacco once more. Sanders has it over the middle. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts, as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. This will be play number 7 on the drive. 3rd and a yard. And again, it's Flacco to throw. Got a man. He finds Sanders. Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. They go pass again with Flacco. And that is caught. Touchdown, Denver. Philip Lindsay there to make the grab as his guys are on the board first here tonight.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now, see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second quarter. Extra point from McManus is good, and it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And the results for them have not been strong to this point. Two drives have ended in a turnover and then a punt.
So would it be too snarky for me to say that they've shown improvement? Because you had two drives with turnovers. Now they punted it away, so at least they didn't turn it over. That's good, right?
You're going to get some angry users reaching out to you on social media.
Well, I don't mean to be. I was actually looking for the positive. Silver lining, you know.
They got a man over the middle. It's Woods. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Here's the Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. They'll be looking to match that touchdown from a moment ago. 7-0 is the score as they begin with a first down.
Here we go.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
47 is the mic, boys, 47.
To throw is gone. It's caught left side by Kurtz. Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second, as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. This will be the first red zone opportunity now for the Rams. They have a first and 10 at the 18. Now Goff. His throw caught right around the 6. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. This gain not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two. The Rams going to be forced to use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. To the air again. Gone. And it's caught for a Rams touchdown by Brandon Cooks. Brandon Cooks. As the first half is winding down. As they are now on the board here in the first half. So a late touchdown here just before the half, and that obviously changes the dynamic of this game.
Yeah, in a couple of ways, partner, because they've been shut out up until this point. So now at least they go into the locker room, and Uncle Mo may be creeping over to their side to talk to them a little bit. And second, they're right back in the football game, an extra point away from tying things up.
Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This will be fielded at the 6. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. Time here for likely one play, and then these two teams will head to the locker room all even.
And you know the play caller's just feeling it right now. Let's go ahead and go for this one. A big shot downfield. Nope. Guaranteed head coach is like, don't get crazy. Take the knee. Let's get out of here. Tie game. We'll just start all over.
Now Flacco. He's got his 6'5 receiver. That's Tim Patrick. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive. 12 yards. Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. Barring a flag, final play here for Flacco and company. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. So thanks to the late touchdown, it's a tie ball game here heading to break. As we'll send you eastward to Orlando, standing by with that EA Sports Halftime Report now is Jonathan Coachman. Take it away, Coach. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Here comes the Broncos' offensive unit here as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. And he got blown up on that play. Back at the 20. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. And never good on a pass completion there to go the wrong way. Lost yardage.
No, for some reason, it seems to work better when you throw it downfield or you can move the ball downfield running it that way, doesn't it? But in this case, if you're the defensive guys, you're energized, executed well, and you caused a lost yardage play. That's going to feel good and look great in film.
The pass there complete to Sutton. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. The Rams calling on their nickel set here defensively for third down. From the gun, Flacco. He's got a man. It's Sutton that's complete. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. A strong 8 yards will keep this drive rolling. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Once more, it's Flacco. Pitch and catch complete to Heuerman. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Flacco will take to the air again. And the Rams got it. They bring him down. Aaron Donald with a sack.
We are seeing two really confident defenses imposing their will on these offenses in this game.
Yeah, absolutely. Going toe for toe. Just curious if one of these offenses can wake up a little bit.
Is there any way they can find something that can pop, something big to knock them back on their heels?
Now after the sack, Flacco and the Broncos come up third and long. Setting up to throw, Flacco. And the pressure gets to him again. The defensive player of the year, Aaron Donald. And that'll bring up fourth down.
And that's his second sack of the game, but this player, disruptive in all phases, whether he's going upfield, coming underneath, you name it. He's a big-time guy you have to block.
The Broncos send out their punter now as he's on to kick it away. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And this one hits at the 3 and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. Now the attention turns back to the Rams offense as they get ready for their first possession of the second half. Their defense did its job, yielded no points. Now it's the offense's turn.
And how much fun is that when you set things up to start a half and you just tell you guys, hey, if you can shut them down, get it back for our offense, we can roll. And they played out perfectly. Now can the offense do what they wanted to do at the half, which is find those weaknesses, and now attack them and score some points.
And break this tie. All that, and it only nets him a yard. It's second down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
On second and 9, Goff. Throw right side, going to be caught by Higbee. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down. Get him,
boys! Well, they were unable to make anything really big out of that, but it's not a bad idea to find your tight end and give him an easy completion and keep moving things forward. Almost as bread and butter as a good running back dive play.
Throwing on third, Goff. And that's complete to Cooks. And he's going to be taken down about a yard shy of the first at the 29. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Here's Johnny Hecker now as he's on to punt for L.A. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Denver offense now as they get set to take over here. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Back in his home state, Royce Freeman getting the carry. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of nine on first down. You think back to 2018, many people thought it would be Royce Freeman taking over as the lead back in Denver. Spent a third-round pick on him, but it was Philip Lindsay who would be in the Catbird seat as the number one running back. But still for Freeman, not a bad rookie campaign, 521 yards and five touchdowns as the backup. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
They tried the throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. They'll try and run for it with Lindsay. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. Nothing doing on second and third down after that nine-yard gain on first.
It's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that, got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Rams will go on offense here with a first and 10. And the Rams now coming out on the field. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. Goff will lead the Rams up here first and 10 at their own 24. They'll start out here with a jet sweep. And they'll get him down after a pickup of eight, second and two.
Anytime the offense shows what they call a shot play or a chunk play where they're trying to get big yardage, sometimes people just call it gadget plays, and you hold it to a gain that we just saw there, you feel pretty good about yourself as a defense.
Now Goff will hand this one to Gurley, and he'll be brought down right around the 37. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. From the gun, here's Goff. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Woods. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it. So it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. They run. It's Gurley. And he'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Here we go, third and one. Gut check time on both sides.
Forty-nine. 180.
Out of the gun. Gone. This is caught. It's Cooks. And he gets it down to the 48. Enough for the first. They call his number again. It's his sixth catch and a first down. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Now gone. Wide open receiver complete. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Back to the ground game here, Gurley. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. The first down run got five. Here's second and five. Goff. This will be caught at about the six. Now the Broncos will use their third and final timeout, and they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. A game-winning field goal would be a chip shot from here. Let's see how they play it on first and goal. They'll try and push it in with Gurley. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Clock 20.
Another try on second down with Gurley. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop it behind the line. It'll wind up being a loss of two. And that's going to bring up an interesting third and goal.
Cut! White 20!
Touchdown, LA! Taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Rams have taken the lead.
And that score, in this time frame, that's like a big reveal at the end of a great movie, isn't it? Out of nowhere, almost, it appears, they get it done. How about that score?
The finishes like this, this is why we love sports, this is why we love the game of football.
So glad that we got to be here to watch this one.
So the LA Rams with a victory here, and it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter
at EA Madden NFL. The Rams are victorious here as we say so.